What's up, everybody? This is Ruben here. This is another video, 60 Vic, 60 days, so forth and so on. Anyways, it was a little disappointing today. I'm going to get right to it here. I'm going to talk about the SpaceX disappointing launch of today. I mean, obviously, you couldn't do anything about it, but first, like, subscribe. Tell me what you guys think. I want to hear about it. I love making these videos, so forth and so on. All the people that have watched, thank you very much. Very appreciative of that. Thank you. So, anyways, they were supposed to launch today around 12:30-ish. It was more like 1 o'clock. They were T-minus 15 minutes, and they aborted because of weather conditions. SpaceX did not launch their first private commercial launch into space with human people on board, with human astronauts on board, right? This is a huge marker. This is a huge, huge time in history. This would have marked a really, really kind of pivotal mark. This would have been something to write about, because this would have been the turning point where now a private company had the authorization, the training. They built the spaceship so that way they can go up in space, dock with the International Space Station, and do it on their own dime, provided there was a lot of funding by the government. You know, NASA and all them gave them a ton of dough. However, they own it, and basically NASA is going to be customers of theirs now, so that way they can go up. And if this was successful today, this would have marked kind of a way to kind of see into the future, right? I had filmed this video already, and I thought about this, and, you know, I was like, I got to shoot it again, right? So to get my thoughts clear, right? So right away, I thought about jobs, right? I'm just going to get this out of the way. I thought about jobs, right? If this is something that is viable, if they're going to go up into space many more times, then private companies can contract these space missions so that they can start exploring viable ways to go up to space on a more frequent basis. So then there's a ton of testing that needs to happen, right? So there's all this infrastructure, there's all this education, all this learning, all these jobs that are going to be needed. Elon Musk and the head of NASA talked about this idea that eventually they want to go to the moon again, have a moon base, have a Mars base. All that stuff is amazing and great, and we should do that. This would have been the first flight that kind of gives us the green light to go do that. If everything went successfully, and everything did go successful in the sense where all the checks and balances had to be cleared, right? Weather was not going to permit them to fly up. Oh, well, they're going to go try again. I don't know if it's going to be tomorrow, or I think the next window is the 30th. But anyways, very monumental. Everybody was watching on the internet. Very, very, very intriguing to see this happen, right? Elon Musk was very excited. But they all talked about this idea to get people excited about space again. There's a huge frontier. And the reason why I brought up jobs and everything is all this exploration, if it can be opened up to the private sector, there can be a whole bunch of avenues of jobs that need to be created. All kinds of machinery, all kinds of systems, all kinds of, you know, you just name it. It goes on and on and on. If you're going to have a moon base, there's so many things that are needed to do that. Quality control, you name it. There's going to be so many companies that could pop up that we can create millions and millions of jobs behind these type of endeavors, right? Who's going to be making the spaceships? Now you can have 4 or 5, 6 different companies. You know, Virgin Galactic and Richard Branson, he can get his thing off the ground now that he saw that it's possible. You know, he didn't have it quite figured out yet, but Elon Musk, you know, he's moving things forward. Boeing is supposed to be launching the same thing. So there's competition. It's not like Elon Musk is the only one in town, which is great, right? You need competition, but this is going to create more and more jobs, right? And so that's what I'm excited about. It's going to push the education. People need to become engineers. It's going to require a lot of higher education. And for these jobs are going to be nice, good paying jobs, right? There's a huge opportunity for you. I see this as millions and millions of opportunities of jobs. You could create, who's going to create the robots? Who's going to create the automated systems, the software design? There's going to be so many things there that are going to be needed so that people have stuff to do, right? You know, everybody's concerned about this whole thing about losing jobs through automation and everything. There's so much that can be done with this whole space exploration that there could be tons of systems involved, and there's going to be new technology discovered and innovated because of the need to go up there on a regular basis, right? A whole bunch of stuff, right? There's all these concerns about the body. Can it last in space? Well, all that's going to get dealt with. All the medical technologies, you know, they have to go up there and experiment and learn and test and learn and innovate and build and build and build and learn and build. There's going to be whole new categories of science that are going to be developed from this, right? It's going to just go on and on and on. So I think this was a good sign. If you're not watching this, you're not intrigued by this, this is something that your kids could benefit from, their kids and their kids and so forth and so on, because this is kind of the next frontier, right? We can explore other planets. People can live on them. You can mine them, right? You can create self-sustaining things on the moon. And then, the refuel, I mean, I can go on and on about this idea, right? So I thought it was disappointing that we didn't fly, that they didn't launch it today, but obviously, weather didn't permit. Mother Nature got them again. But I like this idea. I like this idea that SpaceX was willing to step up. Elon Musk is a real aggressive person that, his aggressiveness to innovate and to get it done is obviously paying off 100-fold. His car company is doing well. His solar company is doing well. SpaceX is doing well. And let's see who's going to be his rival or his competition. So now it's going to be a space race to who colonizes the moon, who goes to Mars, so forth and so on. I just like it, man. It's a real exciting time. And once we get, once we crack this shell of going up in space in a private manner where it's like private companies can do it, now everybody can do it. They can build a spaceship, apply for approval, and get it done. That's what I like about it. Like I said, the whole point of this video was the jobs. There's going to be tons and tons of jobs. So amongst all these weird times that we're living now, this is a beacon of light. And I think that we need to look positively and look forward to this, that there's an opportunity up there for almost everybody. Talk to you guys later. Bye.